It's hard to talk about aggression without talking about alcohol, because alcohol is a major factor in many examples of violence and crime. Alcohol causes aggression for very different reasons compared to the way that drugs such as methamphetamines and steroids cause aggression. Have you heard the phrase alcohol myopia? Myopia means short-sightedness or lack of intellectual insight. Alcohol myopia is a theory that has been developed to explain the effects that alcohol causes on individuals' perceptual and cognitive functioning. Researchers found that excessive intake of alcohol on a single occasion leads the individual to be more sensitive to the immediate environmental cues. It increases an individual's reactivity to what's happening to them in the moment and reduces their ability to regulate their impulses, as well as their ability to think carefully about the future consequences of their actions. Anyone who's had the experience of drinking too much alcohol can relate to a kind of foggy feeling that occurs after you've had too much to drink. You start to lose track of the bigger picture. You can only manage to focus on the people in front of you and what's happening to you at the time. You may have heard the term beer goggles. It's the idea that people become more attractive when they've been drinking. When people are drinking, they're in a bubble where they're not thinking about the future as much as when they're not drinking. This is actually one of the reasons why some people find drinking enjoyable. As humans, we spend a lot of time either reflecting on the past or planning for the future. This is something we're very good at, but sometimes it can become too much. As a result, it can be really difficult for us to think about the here and now. Sometimes we have to do things like meditate and actively think about the here and now to snap ourselves into the moment. Alcohol is actually very good at making people live in the moment, but it can really get them into trouble. When I was a student, I had a friend who used to always procrastinate when he was supposed to be studying for an exam. It was not until the night before he had to sit his exam that he would pull his textbooks out and start studying. Of course, this was incredibly stressful for him. To calm himself down, my friend would have a glass of wine. But then he'd have another and another, and suddenly he'd convince himself that, you know, I don't really need to worry about tomorrow's exam. The exam will kind of look after itself. So after having a few too many glasses of wine, everything appeared to be perfectly fine to him. He'd start playing video games and then forget about his exam. He was more concerned about enjoying himself and having fun than the consequences of failing his exam the next day. And of course, it was really fun for him at the time. But when he woke up the next day, he had massive regrets about what he had done the night before. When people are under the influence of alcohol, they're more likely to initiate violence than when they're sober. People are more likely to swing a punch at somebody because they're not thinking about the what then. What happens after they swing that punch? Even though alcohol is not a primary contributor to violence, as most people who consume alcohol do so without becoming aggressive, there's been some evidence showing an association between the consumption of alcohol and violence. According to the World Health Organization, globally, 5.9% of all deaths are caused by harmful use of alcohol. This equates to approximately 3.3 million deaths around the world. In Australia, data collected between the year 2000 and 2006 shows that around 47% of all homicides have been alcohol-related, and that deaths involving physical altercations, blunt force injuries, and stab wounds have been most frequently associated with alcohol use.